Let's get things kicked off. I am Jeff from the WordPress.com team, coming at you today from snowy Colorado. And before we kick off, I really want to say, on behalf of our incredible WordPress.com team who you see on your Zoom screen, first of all, thank you all for joining us. We really appreciate your time, and we hope this topic and workshop will be of interest and really helpful to you. And also that on behalf of our team, we sincerely wish you health and safety for you and your family and your colleagues wherever you're viewing from today. So thank you all very much. And a quick couple of notes. If you're familiar with Zoom, there's the Q&A feature at the bottom of your screen. We will be very active in Q&A throughout the workshop. We have an all-star team who I'll introduce in just a second that is taking your questions on the fly. And we're also saving a few of those questions for active Q&A with Steve and Maddie later on in the workshop. We're also recording. We're recording this. You'll be able to watch it on YouTube and share it around. And again, please be active with your questions. We hope this is really, really helpful for you. And lastly, we are really well staffed by the incredible WordPress.com team, including Marjorie, Selena, Megan, Jonathan, Ben, and especially a couple of our incredible happiness engineers, Dean and Liz, who are going to be especially helping us take your questions throughout the workshop. Hopefully I didn't miss any of our awesome colleagues, but thank you so much for joining us, everyone. And with that, let's officially kick off how to start selling on your website. And I'm very, very excited to introduce Maddie and Steve.
Hey, everybody. Hope everybody's being safe out there today. Thanks for joining us. Today, we'd like to talk about e-commerce 101, start selling on your website. My name is Steve. I'm a happiness engineer with WordPress.com. Maybe you recognize me from the previous webinar we did, Optimizing Your Site for Business. If you haven't seen that, we'll have a link to it at the end of the presentation. I'd recommend you check it out if you're looking for some more basics about how to set up a website. But today, we're going to talk about how you can start selling on your website. So today we're going to be covering features available with WordPress.com plans, but this information is still relevant if you have a self-hosted site with Jetpack or you have WooCommerce installed. If you're not sure what that means, don't worry, we'll have plenty of time to cover that in the Q&A. Maddie is my co-host today.
Hi, yes, thanks so much, Steve, and thanks to everyone who's joined the webinar. My name is Maddie. I'm also a happiness engineer here at WordPress.com based in Brooklyn, New York. And I'm here to help everybody kind of decode selling on your website. Steve and I both specialize in helping folks achieve their website dreams on WordPress.com. And today I'll be digging into WooCommerce, which is a powerful e-commerce extension.
All right, great. So we have a few resources for you if you want to pull these sites up. The first is a demo site called Casey and Finnegan Therapy. This is a site for therapists providing remote therapy sessions, particularly during this COVID-19 crisis, but also, you know, just in general, if somebody is looking to offer this as a service. They're going to be showing examples of our simple and recurring payments blocks. So feel free to pull this site up and kind of poke around. We're going to be doing some live demos later. So don't be afraid if you don't get this URL just at the moment. Our second demo site is the Paperback Rack, and this site was modeled after a bookstore in New York that's moved to online orders and pickup only. This site utilizes WooCommerce to create a fully fledged online shop. So again, feel free to pull this up and start poking around. We're going to be referring back to these specifically later in the presentation. So firstly, let's talk about why e-commerce. I think a lot of us know what e-commerce is and why it's important, but just a little tidbit of information for you. According to a recent analysis by ACI Worldwide, as of March, that's last month, online transaction volumes in most retail sectors have seen a 74% rise. And it's not that hard to understand why, but it's an important fact to know is e-commerce is going to get more important and certainly something that you're going to want to make sure is integrated into your site or your business. And that's why we're here today. So today we're talking about how to sell products online, and these can be physical goods or virtual or remote services that you're offering. And like I said, we'll see examples of this a little later. We're here to help make sure you have an opportunity to extend your business to your online store. So selling products online, whether they're physical or digital, doesn't require having an expensive plan. But most importantly, having an e-commerce shop also maintains steady income for you, the business. And this is going to be really important, not just for times like these that we're all working through together, but also when we're beyond this and your brick and mortar store is closed, but you want to make sure that there's still a way for people to be purchasing your products. So we have a variety of ways to sell goods and services through WordPress.com that should meet any of your e-commerce needs. And we're going to talk about a few specific ones today. So today we're going to be talking about our payment blocks and WooCommerce. Now, our payment blocks are going to be the quickest option to get you up and running selling products. Think of these kind of like a fancy PayPal button. So you'll sell the product and you can touch base with the customer to sort out shipping and delivery. Very straightforward setup here, not much complexity going on, no need to set up complex shipping options or payment gateways. We're also going to be talking about WooCommerce, which is a full-fledged e-commerce plugin that you can use on WordPress.com and self-hosted WordPress sites. With WooCommerce, you are creating your own storefront. So if the payment blocks are more like a PayPal button, think of WooCommerce almost like kind of like creating your own Amazon store kind of right on your website, and no need to go to any third-party resellers to sell your products through. Everything is built directly into your site. WooCommerce is great because it can scale with you. The sky is really the limit when it comes to adding extensions, being able to have multiple shipping options or accept payment gateways from all sorts of options out there for you. All sorts of options when it comes to displaying products and product categories and all that good stuff. We're going to dig into some of this when we talk about the demos as well. So to kick things off, I'd like to talk about our payment block. So the first block I'm going to talk about today is our simple payments block. And this lets you sell a static product on your website directly through PayPal. So you can see an example here on the slide. At the top is what it looks like inside our WordPress editor. Again, since these are blocks, these are added directly into the editor. No need to integrate any third-party plugin or anything. And I'm going to show you how to add these specifically later. But you can see that the simple payments block really just takes some basic information like a title, a description, the price. You can also change the currency. And then that section for email there is just an email that's connected with your PayPal account. And that's it. And then you can see on the bottom is what it looks like on the live site that people can go and pay for the product. Now, it's important to note that even though we are using PayPal here as the payment gateway, people who are purchasing the product through a simple payments block, they do not need a PayPal account to complete the transaction. They can just use a regular credit card to complete that transaction there. So simple payments is going to be the best option to get things going nice and quickly without involving complex shipping options or anything like that. Everything is going to be handled directly through PayPal, so you'll be in contact with the user to make sure you get them the service, whether you need to ship it to them or provide it to them digitally. Another good thing about simple payments too is you will also get monthly statements that'll kind of give you a recap of the transactions that were on your site. So just a cool thing to keep in mind. The next block here I'd like to talk about is our recurring payments block. And this is more like a subscription type thing, maybe like a Patreon type block here. So you can see an example on the right-hand side for Longreads. You can see that there's multiple plan levels that it lets people subscribe to. We also have options for subscribing monthly and yearly. And this is really great for sites that are providing consistent value to visitors. So if you're writing content like blog posts, or you're posting videos, or you're writing podcasts, or publishing podcasts rather, this is going to be a good option to make sure you're receiving steady income from your viewers. So some other examples too, you could pair this with like a hidden site if you wanted to make sure people could only access specific information once they've subscribed. I actually had somebody yesterday looking to set up a recurring payments block as a way for people to make multiple smaller payments instead of paying for a product for one big set price. So that's another way that you could use this kind of block. And something I'd kind of like to tease as well is in the very near future, we're actually going to have a way that you can gate specific blocks on your site based on if the visitor has subscribed or not. So you'll be able to make sure people have a particular plan and have subscribed to whatever plan you've set, and then people can view the content there. So it's a great way to make sure you're gating content and providing an incentive for people to subscribe. And again, if it wasn't clear, there are ways to also have multiple plans on a site. So you don't have to worry about just having one price point. You can add multiple plans here, both monthly and yearly, to make sure you kind of cover your bases. So these are the two recurring payment blocks. We're going to dive into specific demos a little later, but I'd like to pass it off to WooCommerce. But before I do, a lot of times we get the question like, well, what do I start with first? Do I use these or should I look into WooCommerce? And I would start with these simple payment blocks first. And if you feel like you need more, you need to extend your store, you need a fully fledged e-commerce platform, then begin looking into WooCommerce, which Maddie is going to now cover for us. So
Thank you so much, Steve. Yeah, so let me go ahead and get started into that.
I think I bumped you one extra slide.
Let's go back one here.
There we go.
Let's see. Put a second to load. Perfect. So yeah, I just want to give a brief introduction to kind of what sets WooCommerce apart from the simple mint option. Woo is a full e-commerce solution that can be integrated to your WordPress site. And WordPress.com makes that really easy to use. You can go ahead and install the WooCommerce plugin. In this demo, I'm going to be using WooCommerce 4.0. So if you haven't updated WooCommerce yet, I definitely suggest going ahead and updating. What's awesome about hosting at WordPress.com is that we take care of those updates for you. WooCommerce is a robust e-commerce platform. You can add shipping methods, a variety of payment gateways, robust product features, and a lot more. There are so many great extensions that can be added to WooCommerce to really build out the store of your dreams and to kind of put the way your business model works online. I'll just get into, you know, a little bit about how you can own and create a store here within your website. You don't have to use a third-party service and take users out of your website. You can keep your e-commerce solution here within your site. And you can, in that way, you know, continue branding your store here in with your site and just, you know, allow your store to become an extension of your site. So yeah, like I mentioned, WooCommerce has a variety of shipping options. And when you're moving into using WooCommerce, you can set up shipping methods that work best for your customers. So you can create shipping options based on location or zone. There are some local and flat rate core shipping options built into WooCommerce, but of course with extensions, you can extend that to using things like FedEx, USPS, DHL. You can also set up shipping classes to group similar products together. So let's say you want to group all of your heavy products together or all of your perishable products together. You can use shipping classes to define that. It's just a great way to let your customers choose which shipping method works best for them. In my demo site, the paperback rack, this is a New York-based store that has recently had to go online because of the COVID-19 crisis, and they are offering a local pickup option. So customers can place order online, and then they can come if they've chosen the local pickup option at checkout and pick up their order in the store. So you can create regional shipping methods like this that are really handy. WooCommerce also offers a variety of payment options. So you can offer your customers a payment option that's most convenient to them. So you can set up and manage all these payment options from within the plugin. And then you can also enable payment options based on location. So for the example with my paperback demo here, this store has a cash on delivery option. So if local customers decide that they'd like to handle a local pickup, they can also handle payment locally as well, and they can do cash on delivery when they get there. So little options like this make it really handy to make your store work best for your customers. Something I wanted to mention here, and I went too far, of course. Let me go back one. Yeah, perfect. So something I wanted to mention is that WooCommerce is responsive to all different sizes of devices. So you don't have to worry about if your store is going to work on a mobile device as well. WooCommerce takes the guesswork out of being mobile responsive, which is great for me. I do a lot of shopping on my phone, and I think that that's pretty common these days. So you don't have to worry about your store working on a smaller screen. With WooCommerce, it's responsive by default. And especially when you're working with WordPress.com, all of our themes are mobile responsive as well. So this is a perfect pairing, and you can just basically really take the guesswork out of designing a store that's going to work on an iPad or an iPhone. All of the store features will resize to fit the device, which is super handy. WooCommerce extensions are a great way to go infinity and beyond with your store. So using these WooCommerce extensions, you can set up really any store that you're envisioning. And I just really want to emphasize that while I'm showing on this screen some popular extensions, there are so many extensions, and there are extensions being added all the time. So if you head over to the WooCommerce extension store, you can view all of these there. So, you know, some that I want to mention that are popular are WooCommerce bookings, WooCommerce memberships, Woo subscriptions. These allow you to add really special products to your store. But beyond this, we have multi-vendor extensions. We have auction extensions. There's tax extensions to help you manage taxes through your store. You know, a multi-vendor extension could help you build the store kind of like Amazon, like Steve was mentioning, where you have a lot of different vendors that are able to sell their own products through your store. Or, you know, let's say an auction extension would allow you to set up a site like eBay, where folks are bidding on auctions that are all handled through your store and your site. No need to go to a third-party service. All of this can happen on your site and can be managed by you. So this is your store and you own it. Yay, live demo time. Great.
All right.
Yeah,
cool. So
I'll pass it back over to you, Steve, and I'll let you share your site and give kind of a demonstration of how those blocks work.
Great. Thanks, Maddie. So like Maddie mentioned, we're going to jump over to a live demo. So we're going to show you, I'm going to show you just how easy it is to set up a simple payments block and a recurring payments block on the therapy site. And then we're going to switch over, we're going to switch gears. I'm going to hand it back over to Maddie, and she'll show you how WooCommerce, some of the more in-depth WooCommerce options that you can take a look at. So I am going to flip over here. All right, great. Okay, so this is our therapy site that we created for our previous webinar that we had here. So this site was actually created with our WordPress.com templates that we have as part of our block editor. So we actually just went in and were able to replace the content here to create a site for these therapists to provide therapy services remotely. So if we go to remote therapy services at the top here, we can see this is how people would go to book and then pay for these sessions. So you can see we offer this, the Casey and Finnegan had a 30-minute free consultation. So you can see this is actually a Calendly integration. If you want to know more about this, make sure to check out our previous webinar where we go into a little bit more detail about how this was set up. But today we're going to be focusing on this section down here, which is the remote therapy session 1 hour, which was created with the simple payments block. And you can see this is the simple payments block here on the right. It's inside a column, and on the left-hand side just has a deeper description. And then underneath that here, this is actually a recurring payment that lets people subscribe monthly for recurring therapy sessions. So they don't have to worry about coming back and paying every month. The $90 will be taken out of their account automatically every month, and they can manage the subscription or cancel it on their own. So this looks good on the front end, but how do we go ahead and add this? So I'm going to show you how to do that real quick. So if we go to our dashboard, and we'll go to pages. And this is the page that I added the blocks on, but for the sake of this demo, I'm just going to start with a new blank page. That way you can see how it's built from scratch. I'm going to pick a blank layout. All right, cool. So like I mentioned before, these blocks are integrated directly into the WordPress block editor. No need to fuss around with plugins or anything like that. So in order to add the simple payments block, we're just going to go to the block inserter icon right here for add block. And I'm going to type simple payments to filter it down. And you can see it's categorized under this earn section here. So if I click on simple payments, we'll see the block is added to our page here. And like you can see here, top to bottom, we're just gonna give it a name, description, and then set the price. So let's call this one a 2 hour session. Give it a description. Let's price this at 180 US dollars. We'll go. And we can actually even add a product image here. So we can upload a new one, or if we open our media library, we can select one like that. Cool. So now our block is set. And if I click away here, it'll show what it looks like on the live site here. So that's it. That's all there is to a simple payments block. So people can go and pay. Again, they don't need a PayPal account to purchase this. They can use their regular credit card, and you'll handle the transaction through them. So you'll be in contact with them to set up. In this case, it would be to set up the remote therapy service, whether that's being handled over Zoom or something else. You would work that out with the client, but you would receive the payment through PayPal. Now, for the recurring payments block, we're going to do the same thing. So if we go to add a block here, and I'm going to search for recurring payments. Great. So one thing to note, I already have Stripe set up. Stripe is what is used to handle the transaction for recurring payments. So if this is your first time adding a recurring payments block, you'll see the option to connect to Stripe. So all you'd have to do is click the Connect to Stripe button. We'll take you over to Stripe so you can set up that account and add your business information and all that sort of stuff. Once it's connected, you only have to do that once. Everything will just work naturally and you can just start adding your plan. So you can see when I go to add the block, it actually prompts me to add the block that I've already created. So this lets me quickly add subscription blocks anywhere on the site. Once I create these plans, I can just add these blocks everywhere and then people can subscribe, you know, whether it's on a blog post or my latest video or whatever. But for now, I'll add a new plan. So again, similar to simple payments here, we just need to basically go top to bottom. So let's say 180, and this will be for two remote therapy sessions. And you can see the renew interval here is default set to monthly, but you can also change this to yearly if you wanted somebody to make a yearly payment. And then we click add this plan. And that's it. So now we have the recurring payments button. So if people clicked on this button, they would be taken to the payment gateway through Stripe. We can actually edit this button. So instead of contribution, we can change this to something like per month. However you want to label it. And again, because this is a block, this integrates with all of our layout blocks as well. So you could put this inside columns or layout block. If you wanted a more fancy description, we could add like a heading here. So if we add a heading, say, I'm going to say two recurring monthly sessions. And then I can move it like that. There we go. So now people know this is just a single 2-hour session, and then this is the recurring monthly session. And if we go to save our draft and then click preview, we can see what it looks like on the live site. Not much going on because I started from a blank template, but this is what it would look like if we just publish this page straight up so people can go and go ahead and purchase these plans. So one other thing I want to point out as well, if you want to keep track of this, if we go to under tools, if we go to earn here and then manage recurring payments, you can see this page here actually lists the amount of money that you've earned in the last 30 days, your total earnings, and what you're expected to get next month. And you can also manage your plans here as well. So you can edit or remove these if you wanted to change things up. And if we had subscribers, you could also manage the subscribers from this page here. And lastly, you can also disconnect Stripe if you need to shut down or you need to change accounts. So that is our simple payments demo for this Casey and Finnegan therapy site. Again, we're going to flip over to Maddie so we can take a look at some WooCommerce options. But again, simple payments should be the quickest way for you to get going so you can just start selling products. But if you feel like that's too simple and you need some more complex options, or not even more complex options, you just need more to have a fully fledged store, then WooCommerce is going to be for you. So I'll turn it over to Maddie. I'm actually going to stop sharing my screen so you can share yours.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Steve. Let me go ahead and flip over to sharing my screen here. Let's get into the paperback rack. So every website has a story, and I just thought I'd tell you a little about this website story here. Paperback, which is a bookstore based in Brooklyn, New York. And because of the crisis, they've had to close their doors and move everything online. And they're just navigating that and getting set up here. So I actually built this site using a WordPress.com theme called Couture. Super simple. All I had to do was replace the demo content with some content that was relevant to my store. And I went and plugged in all of that content here. Usually this is an area that's used to kind of introduce customers or users, visitors to your site, to your website, any Couture theme, but I'm repurposing it as a message to patrons who are wondering why the bookstore is closed. So this is a message to let them know that we've had to close our physical store and move online. And then from here, I can go ahead and click on Shop Now. And this will bring me over to the paperback rack store. So I've gone ahead and pre-added some demo products to the store, and you can kind of see just a little bit about how a basic WooCommerce store is set up and laid out here. We have all of the books that we've been able to move online for our customers to shop through. They can sort through them. And then, of course, up here in the top, we have our checkout cart. And I'll just show you a little bit about what that looks like here. So we've gone ahead and added book to our cart, and we can check out. So I think what I'd like to show y'all is just a little bit about how these puzzle pieces fit together and how I was able to create a store that looks like this at WooCommerce, or rather using WooCommerce. So from the WordPress.com home dashboard, when you sign into WordPress.com, it looks a little bit like this. And in order to get to our WooCommerce options and our WooCommerce settings, we'll need to go ahead and visit WP Admin. So to that, you can just click on this link here at the bottom of the regular My Site dashboard. I went ahead and opened up WP Admin already. So within the WP Admin dashboard, you'll notice to the left, there are WooCommerce settings. Before we dive into all of the WooCommerce settings, I'd love to show y'all how to set up your first product. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Products. And here you can see all those awesome books that I've already uploaded, and you can see how products are listed here within the products tab. Notice that the price is listed here. You can see a preview of the product image. You can also see that I've added some categories to my product, kind of sort them and group them together. And I'll go ahead and just click on a product to show you a little bit about how it's set up. And let me go ahead and click on Let's go ahead and click on the book of the month, which is Between Earth and Empire by John Clark. So at the top here, I've gone ahead and added a product title. And then here's our product description. You know, if this was a clothing store, maybe you'd say the clothing out of, if you're selling food, there'd be some details about the ingredients in the food. In this case, because this is a book product, and this is a simple product, but WooCommerce, or using WooCommerce, you can create really a variety of products. You can create a downloadable product, which allow your customers to purchase a product and then receive a link to a file that they can get after checkout. A virtual product is an intangible product that isn't shipped. And you know, maybe a product is virtual and downloadable. We also have something called a variable product, which allows you to add variation to the same product. I'll show you a little bit about what that looks like as well. In this case, this is just a full straight ahead product. I've added a regular price. You could also add a sale price. I've added a category to the product. This is a brand new book, so I've categorized it as just came in. And then down here, I've added my product image as well. So this is sort of the base product setup. Once you've added all this information, this button will actually say publish. Because I've already published this product, it says update. Haven't made any changes, but yep, here's the update button. Once we've published a product, it ends up on our shop page. I'll show you a little bit about that as we move into pages. But before I move on, let me just go ahead and click on Jurassic Park. I went ahead and added a variable to this Jurassic Park product. So, you know, let's say you have a clothing store and you'd like to sell the same shirt in small, medium, and large. No need to create three different products. You can create one product and then create attributes for that product and use those attributes as variations. So in this case, I set up an attribute called version, and the values are paperback and hardcover. But let's say this attribute was called color. And then we use things like purple, blue, green, or for instance, if this was size, you know, maybe we would use small and medium and large. But in this case, we're using version, and our versions are paperback and hardcover. So let's show you what this looks like on the front end. But before we move on from back end, I wanna show you a few more sort of essential WooCommerce settings. So these are the basic product settings. Of course, we have documentation from WooCommerce. that really gets into step-by-step instructions on how to set all of this up. But let's head over in the meantime to WooCommerce and then settings. So there are a couple of really important settings to look over to achieve the look that I achieved in my store demo. One important tab here is payments. And this is where we can decide what type of payment gateways we accept on our store. So WooCommerce has some core payment options built in, and I've enabled those here. I've enabled Stripe, which is a way to accept credit cards on your store. I've also enabled PayPal. And then because we're a physical store that's had to go online, but we're also accepting local pickup, I've gone ahead and accepted, or rather toggled on, cash on delivery. So from WooCommerce settings payments, you can toggle on the payment options that work best for you and are most convenient to your customers as well. There are so many other payment extensions that I haven't enabled here, but you can enable extensions like Square. You can enable Klarna, really, you know, any localized payment gateway that you can think of, there's probably an extension for it. So you'll definitely want to check out the WooCommerce extension store and find the payment gateways that work best for your store. Once you've toggled them on, you can set up the payment gateways from the buttons to the right here. I've already set them up, so my button changed to manage. Another really important piece of the puzzle is going to be shipping settings. So from settings, shipping, go ahead and let this load. We can go ahead and take a look at our shipping options here. So I've set up a couple of different shipping zones, and shipping zones incorporate several different regions, and you can determine which regions are included in your zone and then what methods are used for shipping to those regions. So from this zone, which I've named the local zone, we can say that we can see that this only includes New York. So for local customers, I'm accepting local pickup, and I also have a flat rate shipping option. So maybe you have a different flat rate option for the customers that are based in your local area than you have for customers that are based internationally. WooCommerce allows you to set up the shipping options based on region, and that makes it really handy. Of course, in this demo, I've actually only set up some of the core shipping options, but with WooCommerce, again, you can add in extensions to integrate things like UPS, USPS, FedEx, DHL. There are so many great shipping extensions to integrate into your store to use the shipping options that work best for you and, again, are most convenient to your customers. So in this case, I've set a local pickup shipping option as well as a flat rate option for folks that are located in the United States. The paperback rack doesn't ship internationally yet, but you can also set up a shipping method for locations that are not covered by the zones that you've set up. So for those X factor locations that you haven't set specifics for yet, you can set up a shipping method that covers all of those. And that's another super handy setting here. So you may be wondering, now that you've set up your store, where is the store displayed on your site? And I'll just go ahead and head back to the WordPress.com dashboard here. And if I click on site and then pages, you can see some of the basic WooCommerce pages have been added to my shop here, or added to my site here rather. So we have the shop page, the cart page, the checkout page, my account, so that users can set up their own accounts within your store and manage those. There's a whole bunch of other extensions that kind of integrate with folks' accounts within your store, like membership extensions. But for the sake of this demo, let's go ahead and let's just take another look back at the shop page, and we can see kind of how it all fit together. Here are those products that I created. For my variable product, I can go ahead and choose an option. And then again, here on my checkout page, I can see those shipping options. I'm based in New York, so I'm seeing the local pickup and flat rate option. I can enter in my billing and shipping details here. Because I am based in New York, and I've chosen local pickup, I can actually just do cash on delivery and check out that way. You'll see that WooCommerce kind of takes care of all the formatting, takes care of bringing all those settings to life. And then something else that's really pretty cool about WooCommerce is how it integrates into our block editor. So if I take a look, I actually created a product block demo page here to show off some of the WooCommerce product blocks that we have available. So up at the top here, this product block is a featured product block. So I'm featuring our store's book of the month here. And then these are some product category blocks. So this product category is brand new books, and I'm showing all of the products that belong to that category using this product category block. And then Black History Month is another product category I set up. And I can just show you a little bit about how that's set up on the back end. So this is my product block demo page, and you can see that I've added my featured product here. Is my category, my product category block. And if you just go ahead and add a new block to this page and scroll down, you'll see that one panel of our block selector here is the WooCommerce panel. And from here, there are so many different product blocks that allow you to integrate WooCommerce into all different parts of your site. You know, let's say you write a blog post and you'd like to integrate a feature product into that blog post. This is a great opportunity to integrate those products into other parts of your site, start a conversation about those products, or maybe just show off products that are on sale, your best-selling products, top-rated products. These product blocks really allow you to kind of show your store any place on your site that it becomes relevant. We have a reviews block. Yeah, so that's a sort of quick rundown of some of the WooCommerce getting started settings. Of course, WooCommerce also has a great getting started guide, which we'll link to in our references slide. Before I hand it back over to Steve and back to the slides, I just want to mention that here in the lower right-hand corner of the dashboard is a question mark button, and that question mark takes you straight to live chat. So if you'd like to get in touch with a happiness engineer, if you're working on your site and you get stuck, if you have any questions, we're actually here for you to help. On the business plan, you have access to live chat 24/7. So click on this button, jump into live chat, and let us know where you've gotten stuck, and we can help you along the way. So I'll go ahead and stop sharing on this end, and then we can switch back over to Steve.
All right. Thank you, Maddie. And I'd like to just kind of pick off right where Maddie left off here, talking about, make sure I got the right thing here. There we go. So I just wanted to quickly talk about, talk about the support that we do have available. So we are here for you. It is our job to help you achieve your vision with your site. So whether that's just setting up your site, like you're moving your business online for the first time and you just need help learning how WordPress.com works, or you're looking to get more involved into selling products, whether it's with simple payment blocks or with WooCommerce, we're here to help you out. So with our plans, like Maddie mentioned, we have live chat support, email support. We also do one-on-one sessions. You can talk to us individually. Lots of options to make sure we're out there to help you get what you need. We also have extensive support documentation. And in addition to English, we provide support in, I think, 8 different languages now. So we should be able to meet you where you're at. Lastly, we have some references and documentation here for you. Don't worry about copying these down. We're going to make these slides public and give you a copy along with a survey at the end as well. So you can check this out if you want to go into a bit more detail about some of the specifics that we talked about today. These are just photo credits. And thank you. Thank you for joining our webinar. I hope you got something out of it. We're going to turn it over to Q&A in a second. But Jeff, I'm not sure if you want to chime in here and just let people know what they can get here with their the link that we have, a special discount available for them. So.
Yeah, absolutely. This link, again, will be available to you after the end of today's workshop. We'll include it in the email. This is a discount code for those of you who have registered and attended and joined us today. With that, Just a huge thank you to Maddie and Steve for taking us both through payments and WooCommerce. I should also call out Jonathan, who is a specialist, a community lead for our WooCommerce area, and part of our great team of resources that Steve just mentioned to you. And also behind the scenes, Dean and Liz answering dozens of questions that have come in, great questions from the group too. We won't be able to get to all of them in the remaining time in our Q&A, but rest assured, we're still answering questions in Q&A. We'll follow up by email. And also just can't emphasize enough, there's a lot of great resource links here. And all else, check out support if you ever need it. So with that, I was trying to track all the great questions coming and going throughout the talk. And I kind of grouped them in a couple key areas. There's a bunch of questions about what plan you need for payments and or for Woo. And then there's some kind of help me decide type questions too, which I think those will lead nicely into each other. And then we got some nice specific questions about themes and payment options and so on. So let's start, and Maddie and Steve and Jonathan, feel free to join if you'd like. It could be difficult to summarize verbally, which plan, which tools you have available to you and at WordPress.com plan. But in a simple sense, let me give you a couple questions that came in. For example, what level of WordPress do you need to have in order to use WooCommerce? So let's start with that one. Where does WooCommerce start in terms of WordPress.com plans?
Yeah, so I can jump in with that. So you can install WooCommerce on a business plan or above. So or above would be an e-commerce plan. With the e-commerce plan, you get a lot of awesome Woo extensions. But you can get started with WooCommerce on the business plan. And the business plan allows you to install third-party plugins and themes. So that's kind of like having a self-hosted site at WordPress.com. So you have all the benefits of Jetpack and WordPress.com support, so many other features on the business plan. But yeah, the business plan is where you'll want to start when it comes to installing WooCommerce.
Great. And then similar question, but kind of flipped around. Jonathan, we already have a website. It's not currently set for selling anything. Does it have to be a WordPress.com website, or can we use WooCommerce from another website that they currently have?
It doesn't have to be WordPress.com. WordPress.com is great and it's always getting better, but WooCommerce works with any installation of WordPress wherever it's hosted.
Hey, Jonathan, while I have you, there was a great question that you took head on, and I don't want to put you on the spot, but there was a great question kind of comparing WooCommerce and Shopify. And I thought your answer was great. I don't know if you mind sharing that with our audience.
There's a lot of factors to consider when you choose a platform, but one of the things that we see come up most often is the difference between, we like to think of it like ownership versus renting. Shopify has a lot of great features and functionality. At the end of the day, you're renting space on their platform. Rules change, policies change. And with WordPress and WooCommerce, it's on WordPress. It's open source technology. It's great to use a service like .com who can sort of take care of a lot of things for you. At the end of the day though, if it's on WordPress, it's yours. A lot of other factors as well, but that ownership versus kind of renting we find is a pretty big one.
Great. Thank you, Jonathan. And then Steve, similarly, a few questions about when you can start using the payment blocks that you took us through. First and foremost, can you use those payment blocks on any version of WordPress, or are they exclusive to our WordPress.com customers?
That's a great question. So for the simple payments block, which was the initial PayPal button block, not the recurring payments one, but just the, if you're selling an individual product, that's available on WordPress.com plans on the premium plan and higher. So that's premium business or e-commerce. I believe it's also included with specific Jetpack plans. So if you are a self-hosted site and you're connected with a specific Jetpack plan, I don't know off the top of my head which Jetpack plan includes it, but we can find out for you. Then you can use simple payments block. Recurring payments are available on WordPress.com for any paid plan. So personal, premium, and up, you can use the recurring payments block. The pricing structure, so WordPress.com takes a small percentage of each recurring payment subscription, and we have documentation that covers this as well. So the amount that's taken changes based on what plan you have. So that's how that works. Recurring payments, I would have to double check if that's, I believe it's also included with Jetpack, specific Jetpack subscriptions as well. However, I know some of the newer features, like we were talking about blocking specific blocks unless people subscribe, I know that won't be available to Jetpack right away. So but WordPress.com will get those new features first.
Great summary from all three of you. Thank you so much. It's really important to us to help our users, our guests today, choose the right plan, the right products that you need for your business as you move it to e-commerce. As we look at one more question, Steve, kind of along those lines, do you need WooCommerce to have a shopping cart style setup? Can you get a kind of shopping cart style effect from simple payments or recurring payments?
Good question. If you're looking for, I think people have different things in mind when they talk about like, I want a shopping cart experience, right? I think by that, how I interpret it is like, you want a fully fledged store, right? People can add a bunch of products and then pay all at once and then check out and kind of manage stuff like that. That's what WooCommerce does best. And that's what WooCommerce is for. Simple payments, the transaction is handled per transaction and the same for recurring payments, right? So people go to the site, they click the pay button, they purchase the product immediately right there, you get the notification, you handle everything. You're not adding products to a cart and then kind of checking out all at once. So if that's an important factor for you, then I definitely recommend looking into WooCommerce as the option for you.
Excellent. Well, that leads us into a few questions that are pretty specific scenarios. And all three, feel free to jump in as we try to help our guests choose the right plan, the right products for them. So here's one. Since I offer clients my freelance writing services, is an online store needed? Or would you use simple payments, for example?
Piggybacking on what Steve was just talking about, I think it's a great step to, you know, maybe start with simple payments or recurring payments, see how far you get. And then if you need WooCommerce, you know, you can move on to WooCommerce. What's really cool about WordPress.com and WordPress and WooCommerce is that we're able to grow and scale with you. And so you can integrate extensions as needed, and you can kind of ramp up the way your website is set up on an as needed basis. That way, no need to commit, you know, right off the bat. You can kind of commit as you need those features.
That's great. Thank you, Maddie. I really enjoyed both Maddie's story about paperback rack, as well as just some of the different questions that came in from our audience today that were pretty specific to you and your business or organization. So just a couple more of those, because I think it really helps you picture what the challenge is and what the right solution is for you. For the recurring payment option, would you say that would be a good way to collect donations for a nonprofit organization if they have PayPal already set up? Steve, maybe for you, recurring payments for collecting donations for a nonprofit.
Yeah. I'm not too sure about the latter half of the question about PayPal specifically. But if they have some more detail, I'm happy to fill that in. I think for a nonprofit, for donations, especially if it's something that you want people to be able to contribute to monthly or yearly, I think that's an amazing option for you. And because, like I said, we're going to be rolling out these features where you can block content as well, that gives you kind of an edge when it comes to also incentivizing people to give to your nonprofit, right? So I'm not sure what your organization does, but maybe there's some specific things that you want to make sure, hey, if you donate, you know, you'll have access to, you know, looking at specific products or swag or whatever, right? So I think recurring payments would be super great for something like that.
Great. And then one more fun one to brainstorm. I'm going to sell two kinds of products on my website. One is physical products, the other is digital. Do I create two separate websites or one? And what tools should I use that we've covered today? And I think that's open for the group. Let's start with Jonathan. If you were selling both physical and digital, would you be able to, how would you accommodate that in WooCommerce?
One of the big questions is are they the same audience? If you're serving the same customer, then there's not really a technical reason to separate them. WooCommerce can easily handle physical and digital products and products that are a bit of both too. So like if you're serving the same audience, if it's a similar type of complementary product, then there's not really a good reason that I can think of to keep it separate.
Excellent. And then let's say hypothetically, Steve, if we were looking to sell both physical and digital products using simple payments, my take would be first to echo Jonathan, not to have two different websites, two different properties, because you're kind of missing out on the aggregate effects of having your audience coming to you and finding what you're offering in total. But would you be able to do that to some extent using payments?
Yes, definitely. If you're using simple payments, because you're handling the transaction directly with the customer there, whether you're shipping them a physical product or you're just providing a service, you know, whether you're emailing a download link or a file or a link to a video that's hidden except for them or something like that, then yes, like Jonathan mentioned too, there's no technical reason to separate that. If your audience is the same, you can sell both kinds of products and just work out the delivery with the specific customer that you're working with.
Excellent. One last kind of hypothetical from one of our guests today. Can you use simple blocks to sell gift cards, vouchers, where the value of each purchase might change, might be different?
Ooh, that's a good question. So simple payments, when you create the payments block, it's there's no variation in the specific block itself, right? So one block has one payment option set to it, right? Recurring payments does have an option for pay what you want that might be adaptable to something like that, where you want people to be able to kind of input their own value as to the voucher. I really like that suggestion, though. I think, you know, especially now people are talking about like using gift cards as ways to keep restaurants going, even if they can't physically get there. So that's something I can definitely bring up with our simple payments developers, you know, an option to input their own value so that they can get the voucher that they want. I think that's a great idea.
In the meantime, Woo offers excellent extension support for gift cards, and it's a well-requested and well-developed section. So there's plenty of things that you could do on that side.
Great. For me, the wheels are really turning when it comes to those gated blocks that we're teasing about coming out here soon, and just, you know, gating access to blocks based on subscription. I think that could really come in handy when it comes to downloading files using a simple payment block, or, you know, even accessing something like a coupon code.
That is awesome. Thank you, all three. I really love those questions that help you figure out where to start with how you're going to collect payments or sell products. And then also always thinking about how you're going to grow, how your website is going to grow along with your business. Really helpful to think that through. And those were just a handful of such questions. So again, keep them coming. And we'll, as always, our incredible team is on standby to help you choose the right products and get started. We only have a couple minutes left. I want to make sure we end well before on time. And so just a couple specific product questions. For all these, I would say we have extensive support documentation. We will follow up in the Q&A and in email. But just for fun, there were a few questions that were about collecting payments with options other than PayPal. Jonathan, I think you took one about Venmo. There's a question about Payoneer, which I'm not familiar with. But just in general, what would you say specific to WooCommerce about other ways of processing payments, if there are any, or how you would take that question?
One of the great benefits of WooCommerce as an open source platform is that it has more extension support, more payment gateway support than any other providers. So throughout the world, and we've seen a lot of international questions come in today, there's a good chance there's already a payment gateway for a provider that you're interested in to the Venmo option as well. So you have to do a little bit of looking sometimes. The WooCommerce marketplace is a great place to start. And even outside of that, there are additional payment gateways and additional support. So there's a lot of options to work with.
And similar to Maddie and Steve, there was one question, do I have to pay for Stripe? And pretty proud of our Stripe integration, but any getting started advice to help our audience get familiar with using Stripe?
Sorry.
Go ahead. I'll let you start, Steve.
Cool. I know for recurring payments, because that's what Stripe integrates with when it comes to that payment block, because simple payments is just PayPal. But yes, Stripe does take a small percentage of each sale. I don't know the number off the top of my head, but it's public information in our support documentation that I can make sure we link to.
2.9%.
2.9%.
But there's no ongoing costs.
Right. Thank you.
Yeah, and what's great about Stripe too is that it's a WooCommerce core payment option. So, you know, that's not an extension that you would have to purchase to integrate into your store. That's something that's going to be there when you go ahead and activate WooCommerce.
That is great. Well, we're pretty close to wrapping. There was a question about privacy and security considerations in general. I want to echo something Steve mentioned earlier, both from a payments and rates standpoint. Those can vary by the plan that you use through WordPress.com. There was a number of questions about currencies specific to countries and regions. So for each of those, I hesitate to answer them specifically to the whole audience, but we definitely want to help you solve the challenges specific to where you are and what currencies you're using and what plan you're on. But just in general, for any of you three, would you suggest anything as you're moving your business online? What do you consider from a security and from a privacy standpoint?
I think
that's a good question.
And it's a big question. So thank you, Maddie, for jumping in.
I mean, just right off the top of my head, you know, what I always kind of echo to users in general is just, you're making a great choice by hosting at WordPress.com. There's a lot that we handle behind the scenes. There's a great security support documentation link that everyone should take a look at. But, you know, we're handling a lot of the security back-end stuff for you. And that's just a real benefit of hosting at WordPress.com.
What I'd add to that is like WordPress itself and WooCommerce are excellently built. They're secure products. The hosting is a big factor. WordPress.com is great. There are a number of other hosts out there as well that offer excellent service, but that is a big, pretty big factor, is choosing a hosting provider that you're comfortable with that takes security and privacy seriously.
Excellent. Well, let's end with an easy one. Maddie, there was some compliments to the design of Paperback Rack. What was the theme you were using there? You might have mentioned it, but just to reiterate that.
Yeah. So that theme is a WordPress.com block theme. It's one of our recommended themes called Couture. So, again, you can activate that theme and you can use the themes page templates to replace the demo content with your own content. And for the images, I use the WordPress.com free media library. So I was able to use our source of stock photos, which are just open source photos you can use throughout your site. I copied them to my media library, plugged them into the theme, and I was good to go.
Well, that is awesome. Thank you for so many good questions. There was also some questions looking ahead. What other types of workshops might we be offering in the near future? So I think that's a good way to wrap it. I want to encourage everyone to do a few things after today's workshop. You'll get an email with a survey in it. Please do fill out that survey. Give us your ideas and your requests for additional topics that you'd like us to cover in the coming weeks and months. There'll also be that discount code that Steve mentioned earlier that will be included in the email, as well as a link to this video that you can watch and share. Please do share as well. A huge, huge thank you, first of all, to our large audience today that asked tons of great questions, and to Dean and Liz behind the scenes, and especially as well to Jonathan and Steve and Maddie for taking us through today's workshop. I enjoyed it. I hope it was useful to everyone else. And with that, thank you all very much, and we will wrap right there.